Hey, look at John, will you?
What's the matter, John, love? Blue meanies?
Newer and bluer meanies have been sighted within the vicinity of this theatre. There's only one way to go out.
How's that?
Singing!
One, two, three,
They were the Fab Four. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're taking a look at the history of the Beatles. Rock band The Beatles formed in 1960 in Liverpool, England. The group originally consisted of guitarist John Lennon, Paul McCartney, and George Harrison, along with bassist Stu Sutcliffe and drummer Pete Best. Much of the group's early time was spent playing shows in Hamburg, Germany. McCartney then took on bass after Sutcliffe's 1961 departure, and they began recording as a backing band. After meeting their future manager Brian Epstein, the Beatles were signed to EMI's Parlophone label by producer George Martin in 1962. That same year, Ringo Starr replaced Best during their first recording session, and the classic Beatles lineup was solidified.
Love, love me do.
All four members contributed vocals, but Lennon and McCartney's singing and songwriting partnership stood out. The group released two successful singles before their number one 1963 debut, Please Please Me. And followed that with two more hits. As they toured the UK in 1963, their popularity generated frenzied fan reactions dubbed Beatlemania. That year, the foursome also released the chart-topping LP with the Beatles. Next came their first number one single on the Billboard Hot 100 chart. The song and their first 1964 appearance on The Ed Sullivan Show kickstarted the British invasion in America.
Hang on! This is a song.
Shut up, Ollie's talking!
Yes.
Screaming fans continued to pursue the band on their international tour dates in 1964. The group also starred in the successful comedy A Hard Day's Night and released a popular soundtrack. That year also saw the UK release of the number one album, Beatles for Sale, and the US release of the chart-topping record, Beatles 65. The next year, their second film, Help, and a number one soundtrack that featured the song Yesterday, came out.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away.
The Beatles recorded the folk rock LP Rubber Soul amid growing tensions. That effort showcased the band's musical and lyrical progression and is often considered one of the greatest albums ever made.
He's a real man.
In 1966, controversy arose when Lennon commented on the band's popularity.
Are you burning your Beatles records?
Yes, sir, I burn them.
You burn them all yourself?
I've already burned them.
Despite this, the band continued to crank out hits. They also topped the charts with the psychedelic rock record Revolver, and this was another triumph.
I look at all the lonely people.
After their final tour came the 1967 record Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. The effort's successful mix of musical genres and its use of varied instruments and sounds made it one of history's most important pop albums. The Beatles' song All You Need Is Love premiered next and was followed by a meditation retreat in Bangor, Wales.
That was kind of stunning because we were off on this sort of finding the meaning of life and there he was, dead.
Following the shocking death of Epstein, the Beatles released a successful psychedelic rock soundtrack to their poorly reviewed Magical Mystery Tour film. In 1968, the well-received animated movie Yellow Submarine,
It's All in the Mind,
and corresponding soundtrack were followed by the Beatles' first single on their label Apple Records.
Na, 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 na,
After visiting the Maharishi Mahesh Yogi in India that same year...
It was a bit of a phase, but he's still a nice fella and everybody's fine, but we don't go out with him anymore.
The group released a self-titled LP, commonly known as the White Album. Despite tension-filled recording sessions and Lennon's romantic fixation with Yoko Ono, the record topped the charts. Over the course of their 1969 recording sessions for the album Let It Be, the Beatles began to fall apart. During this time, they made their final live performance on the rooftop of their recording studio. Don't let me down. Unable to resolve their issues, the Beatles put Let It Be on hold and began work on Abbey Road. They released that album later in the year, and it became one of the group's most commercially successful efforts. Though it was recorded before Abbey Road, Let It Be was the band's final album release. It was finally released in 1970, along with an accompanying documentary.
I'll play, you know, whatever you want me to play. Or I won't play at all if you don't want me to play. No, whatever it is that will please you, I'll do it.
By this point, both Lennon and McCartney had started releasing solo material.
Maybe I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time.
Oh,
despite their subsequent breakup and the deaths of Lennon and Harrison, the band's popularity did not diminish with time. The members continued releasing solo albums, and many projects were released with and without input from the band.
Let me take you down.
Some of the most successful of these included the Beatles' anthology documentary and Cirque du Soleil's theatrical production, Love. The Beatles were artistic innovators who quickly achieved massive success. With their colossal pop culture influence, it is without a doubt that their musical legacy will live on.
Thanks, Mo.
I'd like to say thank you on behalf of the group and ourselves, and I hope we pass the audition.